Ralph, this is Shitbird. When I die and I get to heaven, I'm definitely going to kick your ass and return the favor. Love you, Ralph.
I'm kind of sorry you had to go through all this stuff. But, well, anyway, this is going to be your resting place. I hope you're going to be a lot happier in heaven than your friend in here.
I know we met a couple times down in England by Saki's yard. You know, we probably had some beers together. Well, we'll have some beers again soon. Well, not too soon, but soon enough. I'm sorry we couldn't get you out, but the weather just wasn't cooperative. But we got a beautiful day in one of the most beautiful places in New Jersey right here. So I hope this works for you.
Hello, Ralph. It's I, Jarrah. Hey. I wish we could have met in person at some stage, but I want to thank you for all the time and support that you've given over the years. And I know a lot of people wanted to be here, but they couldn't, but I can let them speak for themselves. First of all, I have this message from Rick, who was the guy who found the solar data that I am deeply sorry I wasn't here to say my farewell to Ralph. It's been nearly 10 years since Ralph's work became part of my consciousness. His courage and dedication to the truth helped open my eyes. I will never forget his contribution to my personal awakening. For every soul out there whose Ralph's life touched, I would like to offer my sincerest condolences at his passing. I know his integrity, honesty, and courage will continue in our collective spirit. Peace. Rick. This next one is from Ruchi Miriov. René was a pioneer and certainly a brave man. Saying publicly what he did was regarded as complete madness by people who could not believe a conspiracy of this magnitude could possibly exist. I recently went to discuss Astro Brand 2's video, which tries to make René appearing as a fool. But what I learned there is that René was a skeptic. A person who doesn't take granted everything told and shown to him, but questions if this is right. However, it is people like him who make science and civilization advance. We, the Apollo Troopers, and the Troopers in general, are on a mission to get the information out from the archives to the light of day. We may be proven right or wrong, but we are needed all the same. If there are enough of us, and we are loud enough, tomorrow we will build on transparency and openness instead of secrecy and corruption. And thanks to pioneers like René, there are more of us, and we are louder. His time here was well spent. Take care. This one is from Greg Kilana in Seattle. Dear Ralph, you have left a legacy behind you probably never fathomed. But thank you from the bottom of my heart and all of ours for sparking our minds to always seek the truth, not only concerning the moon, but causing a ripple effect that has affected my life in ways I never imagined. Back when I was a little kid in July of 1969, believing Armstrong actually stepped onto the lunar surface. And it wasn't until people such as you and Bill Casing woke me from a 3+ decade sleep that I actually felt enlightened for the first time in my life. Your fans will forever be grateful for your integrity to uncover the evil lies of NASA. Let the spirits in the sky rest your soul in a cosmic tranquility. Just one of many you will always be a hero to. Greg Kalina in Seattle. This one is from in Melbourne, Australia. Sometimes you got it wrong, but most times you got it right. There should be one of you in every science department to keep the rascals honest. Ralph, so long and thanks for all your help. We'll be missing you. As with the loss of a close relative, the death of American writer Ralph Rene leaves us theorists shocked and deeply saddened. Ralph was one of the most vocal and recognized experts on unraveling the moon hoax, the greatest scientific swindle of the 20th century, perhaps the greatest scam of all times in human history. He wrote NASA Mooned America in 1992, long considered the most leading, comprehensive, and compelling book on the subject. The book was defined as far superior to We Never Went to the Moon by the author himself, Bill Kaysing, who was considered the father of the theory of the hoax. On the 8th of December, Ralph was severely injured in a car accident, which heightened the pain and worsened his previous debilitating condition. On December 10th, not being able to withstand the pain anymore, he took his life. He was 75. He had waited for a badly needed operation, but after years of arthritis had rendered him disabled. But his malpractice ensues forced him, in league with his doctors, to be subjected to a pre-operation stress test that in his condition he could never pass. And thus he was denied a fundamental human right of access to medical care that would have ended his long suffering. A right that is freely given in many rich and poor world countries. Dramatic irony. Here we have the so-called greatest democracy in the world that boldly swears that 12 of its citizens have walked on the moon between July 1969 and December 1972. And yet today, in 2009, this same country is not able to grant surgical care to another citizen despite having the necessary medical insurance. For those 50 million Americans without health insurance, they will definitely need God on their side to work his miracles to prevent any sickness and ill health that they may endure in the near future. While the many astronauts, as well as movie actors that took part in this lie, have become multi-millionaires, obtained university chairs, and live in the splendor and luxury in the green sea of tranquility in Maine or Texas, their wealth affords them the luxury of access to medical care with or without health insurance. However, theirs of longevity could be revealed worse than a true death. In Gospel, we read, "For there is nothing covered that shall not be revealed, neither hid that shall not be known." Luke 12:2. Already the White House is tormented by the idea that someone can send automatic probes to the moon and take photos of the surface. From these photos, the truth that's waiting up there will emerge. There is now another space race, this time between China and the United States. The Chinese are gearing up to get to the moon by 2015. The US can't envision getting there till 2020. So the Obama administration wants to collaborate with the Chinese in an obvious attempt to interfere and slow down China's burning desire to get to the moon. Nevertheless, the hoax will be revealed sooner or later. When the truth is revealed that America did not go to the moon, we will surely know we have been lied to, creating derision and anger in the streets, and for the surviving astronauts and NASA, only shame. We all would have hoped Ralph Rene had resisted till that moment, maybe near, because in 2009 it recurs the 40th anniversary of the hoax. And after 40 years, the classification of top secret documents expires. Then the entire moon operation, including films, can all be revealed, the analysis of which will carry some surprise, assuming they have not been lost. As many know, the original films disappeared from the NASA archives in the summer of 2006 and have never been retrieved. Rest in peace, Ralph Rene, great American hero. No more shall you suffer in body, but we are with you in spirit. Albino gallop in it.